वेलकम टू इंग्लिश विद सर ताहिर। आर टुडेज़ टॉपिक इज़ प्रेजेंटेशन स्किल्स और इफेक्टिव प्रेजेंटेशन स्किल्स। द डेफिनेशन ऑफ अ प्रेजेंटेशन इज़ अ मीन्स ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन विच कैन बी अडेप्टेड टू वेरियस स्पीकिंग सिचुएशंस सच एज टॉकिंग टू अ ग्रुप, एड्रेसिंग अ मीटिंग और ब्रीफिंग अ टीम। प्रेजेंटेशन स्किल्स फॉलोइंग आर द स्टेप्स इंक्लूड इन प्रिपेयरिंग इफेक्टिव प्रेजेंटेशन। First thing is plan, then prepare, then practice and present. What is planning? These are the 5 WH questions you have to ask yourself. Who is your audience? Why are they there? What is your goal? How long will it be? Where will it take place? Then prepare. Number 1 is a structure. Number 2 prompt. Then visual ads, voice, appearance, style and questions. First, try to understand the structure. In your structure, first thing is your objective. Then beginning or introduction. Main content, summary, conclusion and recommendations, questions. Prompt, short bullet points, keywords only. Put your entire prompt onto your PowerPoint slides. These prompts are for you. Then visual ads. Use simple fonts, colors and graphs. Use images and clip arts. You can see simple color and font size in my PPT presentation. Images, you could say visual images, 3 to 7 bullets per slide. Don't overcrowd your slides. It will not look professional. Now or different. New different visual ads wake people up. In this PPT you can see the only 4 or 5 bullet points, and through visual you can understand the PPT. It has become easy to understand. If I included more bullet points, it would be difficult, would have been difficult to understand. Voice louder and clear than your normal pitch. Vary pitch and volume, overemphasis. After that, appearance. When you are going to give your presentation or effective presentation in front of an audience, so you have to look after your appearance as well. So number 1 bullet point is dark colors. Read as business-like. Wear comfortable shoes to weight your feet evenly. Allow yourself to move a bit. Look confident. Then style. You already have a style. Don't try to copy others. Use words and sentences you use in normal days. Be yourself. Style means you can copy anybody else at some extent, but you cannot 100% copy someone else. So it will be called a parody. It will not be your natural style. You have to follow your own natural style. You have to be yourself. If you do not follow your own way, so it will be simply a parody, not your own style. Questions. Sketch an idea that what kind of questions audience may ask. So you always have to be prepared. If you are well prepared regarding your presentation, so you can answer any questions. Then preparation material. You can use following items to make the content of your presentation. Handouts, personal notes, internet, visual ads. Definitely if you have handouts, so you can distribute to your audience. Personal notes, if you forget something, internet. Internet is helpful for you for your presentation. You visual ads, the visual ads you can see in my presentation, so it becomes easy to understand for the audience, for people, because our language should be easy, short and concise for an effective presentation. Then practice. Rehearse all points what you prepare. Rehearse with all visual ads and handouts. Practice again and again to manage time. Rehearse in front of mirror or a friend. Basically, when you are going to give a effective presentation in front of an audience, so you have to practice again and again, you have to rehearse again and again, you have to over rehearse or over practice. You have to be well confident in front of an audience. How can you be well confident if you have good practice? And practice makes a man perfect, we know very well. Then present. If you have done a great practice, then you are going to present it. Make a strong start, engage the audience in first 2-3 minutes. Show your passion through your movements and gestures. You have to use your body language and gesture postures. Make an eye contact. Don't forget to smile as well, unless your topic is very grim. Flows in presentation make like this. People make people like this. People may sleep, people may see here and there, feel headache. So we can understand the factors: lack of experience, lack of enthusiasm, lack of practice, lack of related material, lack of confidence, hesitation, ambiguity in the results that you want to conclude. These things make your presentation like this. The effect of your presentation, it will not be effective, it will be like this. Flows will be there and people will not take interest in your presentation. Factors for successful presentation: be over prepared. As we have discussed earlier, that you have to practice, you have to rehearse a lot. Rehearse and practice. Grip on your topic, know your subject, be positive, avoid stress. These factors make your presentation effective. At the end, in conclusion, I would like to say that always prepare, channelize your fear, interact with your audience. It will make your presentation effective. Thank you for watching.